Welcome back into the nest for more intimate chats with the lovebirds. Now, with more discussion about love, sex, and relationships, here are Drs. Chuck and Joanne Bird.
Welcome back, and we are here. This is the final segment with Intimate Chats with the Lovebirds. That's right. And we just had our fantastic guest on, which was Caroline Hatton, licensed mental health counselor. She's not only a colleague of ours at our practice, attainablesolutions.net, but she is also a friend. So that's we always love having her on as our parenting expert. So this is one of my favorite segments.
Definitely a gear switcher.
Yes, it is.
So talking about children and their schedules to let's go to the sex toys.
We're going to the bedroom now.
This is how we're
going to
relate it, though. I'll bring it in. If you can get those schedules working for you, then that gives you more time for the couple.
That's right. So sometimes you have to plan these things.
Yes, plan these things. Routine.
Structure, all that
stuff. We definitely learned.
That's right.
So anyways, as everybody knows, we're Cal Exotic Sexperts. Sexperts.
Yes.
And we get toys to review every month.
It's a tough job, but, you know, somebody's got to do it.
And what we do, though, is we get three of them. So
yes.
Two of them get to go to our tester couples.
Yep, they are couples.
And they test them, and then we get the feedback from them, and then we put our feather rating
and
scale.
For those of you that are now listening for the first time, yes, because we are the Lovebirds, we have to have a feathers rating
scale.
That's right.
So
it is one feather, not so hot. Five feathers, very hot.
You're going to need all five feathers to cool you off.
That's right. And so the product that we got is the Lighted Shimmers. It is an LED Bliss teaser with extreme power.
Bum, bum, bum.
And for those of you, I'm going to show this little package here that are listening. And what it is, it's got a base. I'm going to describe it for the listeners that aren't watching. It's a base. It has the batteries that go
in there. Yeah, it has a control, handheld control that looks like a jewel almost.
That's right. It's pink.
It's pink, has a jewel, and it has a little... like it's almost like a dimmer switch, like more power, less power, more power, less power. And then it has, of course, the vibrating end here with a cord attached to it. And
it requires three batteries.
Three AAA batteries. Mm-hmm. It does light up. The actual vibrating part lights up. So I guess if you're in a very dark room, you know where people are.
In fact, that's what they suggest with this, that you turn the lights off. You want to do that in the studio here. And you turn... Oh, look at that. It turns on. See? That's what's fun with these things.
Never know what's gonna happen.
All of a sudden, he turned it on me. And so here it is, guys. Listen. That's it. For those of you, I have to do the sound effects for people to hear.
It sounds like a lightsaber.
Yes, it is. It's a very small lightsaber.
It is. Very tiny.
Luke.
Sounds like it's pretty powerful, though. Okay.
It's not a lightsaber. Anyway, it's a very small pink bullet here, and it does light up.
It does. Look at that thing.
Yep. It does light up. You know me with these things. I like to actually just play with them on the table.
Yeah, you do.
Because they just bounce around and it's great. Anyway, so we have a rating scale that we give, rating criteria that we give to our couples. And it's based on nine things. Okay.
Yeah, we give them nine different questions to answer and, you know, to kind of give us a feel for the toy.
So let's talk about them. So did it deliver enough power to get the
job done?
Mm-hmm.
Now, one said way too much power. Way too much.
Too powerful. It is kind of powerful.
Yeah, I mean, because think about that. When I turn that all the way up,
it won't even work now.
Okay.
Yeah. Anyway.
So the second answer, the second couple, this is going to relate.
Yes.
Okay. It says, I could not get the product to work. Tried new batteries, checked the directions, but had no luck.
And in this one, to be honest.
The one that we are demonstrating now, I even had some issues with it.
I put
the batteries in. I had to sit there. I finally figured out if you touch the battery. You touch the batteries and it works. Then when I close the lid to the battery compartment, it shuts off.
Yeah.
So it's all about, I think it's just a connection problem.
Right.
And, it goes on and off,
which could be very frustrating or pleasurable, depending on what you're That's right.
Oh, it's on. No, it's on.
Exactly.
So the second one was What was the noise factor? Was it, you know, the vibrator incredibly loud for the situation where we're using it in? Did it wake the neighbor, so to speak? The first one said noise level was appropriate for the situation. The other one said, of course, who knows? Can I get the product to work?
And that's frustrating when you get a new toy and you're like, work!
Make it work!
And it didn't, but anyway.
Right. Number three, was it easy to use? Meaning, did you have trouble understanding directions, how to put it together? Again, you know, difficulty putting batteries in, blah, blah, blah. So the first one said, yes, it was pretty easy to use.
Very simple. Yep.
The other one, of course, batteries were common size, easy to install, but there was no information about controls and not that it ever worked.
And the fourth question is it discreet looking? Did you like the overall look? And it's not bad. I mean, they're trying to make it very kind of sparkly and glowy, and it's pink.
It's pink.
So,
definitely pink.
Yeah.
The first one said there's nothing discreet about a pink blinking sex toy.
they're like, yeah, this would definitely
be you couldn't hide that one in and go, what the, okay.
Yeah, this would be quite noticeable. Yeah.
The second one said it looked very interesting. I wonder what parts would light up and if the larger section was just a remote or if it vibrated
now,
too.
Now, on this particular couple, you can sense the frustration of having a toy that is not working in the answers. But go ahead.
The next one, was it easy to clean? When cleaning it to according to manufacturer X-ray. First one said yes. Second one said there's no instructions on cleaning included.
So there you
go.
She
wasn't sure.
And also, would you recommend this product to somebody else? And both said no. I think this is one of the first toys we've received from Cal Exotics.
Yeah, probably not and no. Yeah.
Exactly.
So,
and did both of your partners enjoy it? One said...
Variable speeds would have been nice. Although, with the thing, I felt it was a little bit...
It didn't have a lot of variation.
But it was just either really high or really like less high. Maybe.
Exactly.
You know. So, and then the very last one that we always ask, how many feathers would you give it?
That's right.
The first one that was giving, you know, that actually got it to work, gave it only two feathers. Only two feathers. And then the second one, of course, that didn't get it to work, did not give it any feathers at all.
So, drum roll, please.
So
there we go. We gave it one feather. Not so hot.
So yeah. It's in a way, I think it kind of is more of like a novelty.
Exactly.
You know, like it's more of a, it's kind of neat looking. It's interesting. It's fun. There's a light up, you know.
It's fun when it works.
When it works, it's fun.
Yeah. You know, now, I will say for Cal Exotic, though, in their defense, if you ever receive any of their toys, you simply call them. They have great customer service.
Yes, they
so
do.
So it may have been just something with this toy, because this is, like I said, the first one we've received that,
Actually, I think two of them didn't work.
Exactly.
Out of the three we get. Yeah.
So that's unusual. That's unusual. So I'm thinking this is this toy. So not so hot on the lighted shimmers.
Lighted shimmers.
Only one feather.
Yeah.
Boom, boom.
It sounds like next time.
Exactly. Well, we'll look forward to the next one that comes in.
Definitely, definitely.
But I still love that segment.
Oh,
I just love playing
with
these things.
It's always fun. I know. When you can get it to work, you can...
Yeah. Like I said, it's... Yeah, it is like a little snowman, Caroline.
It is.
That's
a
right.
Pink
you work with kids. Although, yes, did you notice last time Caroline was on the show with that? It was the Smurfs.
Yes.
Yeah,
so the Smurfs and the Green Hornet. And
I'm noticing this pattern.
Yes, it is.
And Russell's back there saying it's a mini-me lightsaber.
Mini-me. There you go. It's a mini-me lightsaber.
So that's what this looks like here. So there you go. Anyway, so next week we will be back again. Yeah. And we are I think next week is going to be a surprise show.
Yeah, because we're still kind of up in the air with
what's going to be happening.
Coming on. So we're going to, it's going to be up in the air show.
That's right. It's an
it's
up in the air show. That's right. As always, guys, you can give us a call at 866-826-1340 during the shows. You can always go to our website. We hope you all have a wonderful Friday, a great weekend.
And celebrate that equality.
That's right.
Women's equality. And remember, enjoy your wine, but drink it responsibly.
And as always, wishing you more connection and passion in your relationship. See you next week.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.